We're back with Ellen Kunis and Francis Largeman Roth of Health Magazine. They have a new book out, and the title makes it sound like the best book ever written. Let's take a look at it.
It is the best book ever written.
What is it called?
The Carb Lover's Diet.
The Carb Lover's Diet. Now, okay. How does this work exactly? Because I always thought, I mean, the biggest thing a couple years ago was that carbs are bad.
So for the past 20 years, we've been hearing that carbs are bad, but that's not true.
Right.
You know, it's all about eating the right carbs.
And you know what? There have been, some 200 studies now that show that eating carbs is the best thing for you. There's one, in fact, that says that the people who weigh the least eat the most carbs. People who weigh the most actually eat the fewest carbs. So carbs are good. That's the most important message.
So what's the secret to your book? How do people lose weight by eating carbs?
Okay, so there's an ingredient called resistant starch. And resistant starch is a type of carbohydrate that's actually resists digestion in the small intestine and kind of acts like a fiber. Helps you feel full on fewer calories. It also kicks up fat burning in the body.
Really?
Yes.
Which is very exciting, and especially when you get it at breakfast time. So right. If you get about 5 grams of resistant starch in your breakfast, it's going to kick up your fat burning by 25% for the day.
Right, and you only need to get about 10 grams or so of resistant starch over the course of the day. So if you get it at breakfast, and it's pretty easy to do, mm-hmm. half a banana will get you there. One banana.
Slightly green. Banana.
Okay, thank you very much. Your fat burning will be kicked up, and you're going to burn a lot more fat. You're going to lose weight.
So what are some other examples of foods that have resistant starch?
Barley, brown rice, whole wheat pasta, beans, basically all beans, peas, even potato chips.
And potatoes. Mashed potatoes, well, baked potatoes.
Yeah, potatoes in any form. But what's really cool and what a lot of people get excited to hear is that when you let these foods cool, so you let pasta cool, you let potatoes mm-hmm. cool, it actually doubles the resistant starch. So better to have your potatoes as a potato salad than hot. Right.
Really? So how would that happen? Why is it that if you're eating the same product, why would the temperature change the contents?
Because the starch molecules actually break down during the cooking process, and then when they're cooled, they reform. Right. So that's why there's more starch in the cold product.
I mean, the really interesting thing here is that people feel really full. That's part of what resistant starch does. So when you eat it over the course of the day, you feel full, you don't have cravings for other kinds of foods, you stay on the diet. So what we're finding is people are losing weight as much as 6 pounds in 7 days. They're losing 12 pounds in a month. And the most important thing is people on the Carb Lovers Diet are keeping the weight off.
And they're happy.
Yeah, they're enjoying.
They are happy. Most people on diets are cranky. You know what I'm talking about. And we have dieters who they're so thrilled to be eating the foods that they love and losing weight at the same time. We have one gal who lost about 50 pounds. She looks like Katy Perry now. I kid you not.
Wow.
Because carbs make you happy and they make you full.
So how does a diet work exactly? Is it just that you're supposed to eat a certain amount of resistance carb foods in the morning?
All throughout the day. So, and we have menu plans in here, which are filled with our really delicious, we have 75 delicious recipes, including this cherry,
our
ginger,
personal favorite,
scones.
Yeah. Are you serious?
I'm serious.
This stuff is great. These are so yummy.
I love a good scone, I have to say.
We're having this for breakfast.
Really?
Yeah.
So you can eat these scones and actually lose weight.
Yes. You can. And what I think the real sort of surprise about the diet is that instead of having really skimpy, super light meals, they're actually very full. They're 400 calorie meals, which is, you know, that's a 350 calorie scone right there. You could still have a small glass of juice, but it's about not being hungry.
Right.
And what about the butter, all the butter and sugar that goes into these scones? Doesn't that offset what the resistant starch might be doing?
They actually don't have much butter or sugar. There's a really
small amount of brown sugar. Only a half a cup of brown sugar for the whole batch, and we've added whole wheat flour and some oats to the batter.
And cherries and ginger.
Mm-hmm.
The cherries and ginger add sweetness and flavor, and that makes them really amazing tasting.
So it's not your average scone. This is your recipe.
It's our very special.
Okay.
Not from the big shop.
Just wanted to clear that up. So tell us a little bit about what we should be doing when we go to these holiday parties. Mm-hmm. There's eggnog, there's scones, there are cookies, pigs in a blanket. What can people do to pick the right snacks?
Well, the first thing you want to do is make sure that you're eating resistant starch-filled carbs before you get to the party, because that way you're going to feel full and you're not going to be as likely to start grabbing everything that you see. That's number one. But then when you actually
don't
arrive
hungry.
Right. And you're not going to if you eat these carbs that we're recommending.
But then, you know, seek out the resistant starch at the buffet table. So things like tortilla chips have resistant starch in them. So 5 tortilla chips and 1/4 cup of guacamole or bean dip, bean is another resistant starch food, is only about 150 calories. So look for things that are gonna fill you up. So those higher fat foods like the mini quiche and the pigs in a blanket, they're tasty, but you need to eat, you know, 4 or 5 of them to feel satisfied. So look for things with fruit and veggies, and then again, those resistant starch carbs.
Right. And your potato chips are great too. Yeah. You can have a handful of potato chips.
I just cannot believe that you can eat potato chips and actually lose weight. Potato chips are deep fried in oil.
About 24 has a gram of resistant starch, makes you feel full. And you know what? Eating those kinds of foods, like potato chips, we also say you can eat chocolate on this diet. They satisfy
and
you.
Wine.
They make you feel like life is worth living, that you can enjoy yourself and lose weight. And that's the secret to this diet.
So how does one get on this diet? You know, just walk us through your book a little bit. You have a 7-day kickstart guide.
Right? Yeah, 7-day kickstart plan, and that is what is getting people to lose about 6 pounds a week. So you follow that for a week, and then you move to a higher calorie immersion plan that's for 3 weeks or 3 months or however long you want to follow it.
You get to eat a little bit more. There's a couple of snacks thrown in there. But people are still losing weight steadily, and they feel really energetic and full. We have people now who've been on the diet, 6, 8 months, and they're still at the weights that they want to be at, their happy weight.
So explain to me a little bit why carbs have been so demonized. You know, is it a different type of carb that people say you shouldn't have, or, you know, was it just a big hoax?
Well, there are a lot of refined, junky, carbohydrate-rich foods out there, you know, and we can access them pretty much anywhere we go. There's a lot of refined flour, refined sugar out there. And so those are all foods that, you know, again, having them once in a while is not going to hurt. That's not what is creating the obesity epidemic. It's just that eating far too much of that stuff that doesn't make you feel full. It's refined to the point where all the fiber's gone, all the resistant starch is gone.
Right, and they're all empty calories and very highly processed. Right. That's what's a real problem.
So should you go for the whole wheat carbs?
Yes.
As much as possible,
you know, that's always a healthy choice because it's not just the resistant starch. Whole grains are really good for you as well. But, you know, yes, and if you can cook for yourself, that's always a good choice, but you can also follow carb lovers by going to, you know, quick-serve restaurants and eating frozen foods as well.
Right.
So you can do it both ways.
But the great thing, actually, about carb lovers is that the diet recipes that we have are really fast and really easy, not with weird ingredients. They're things you're going to find in your refrigerator, in your cupboard. So that's why people are finding it really easy to stick with, too.
And they're not too expensive.
That's great to hear, because I feel like every time I look at
bananas, potatoes, right. I mean, but let me say this. You get to eat hamburgers, but you get to have it with a bun.
That's true.
You get to eat
with
pasta.
The bun.
With the bun.
Tacos are one of our dieters' most favorite recipes.
Yeah.
And also just want to point out, you can go to carbloversdiet.com to get a whole bunch of the recipes. And,
carbloversdiet.com.
And also see some success stories as well.
Yeah.
So how did you guys come up with this, you know, new idea for this book? Is this something that's been around for a long time that people have known about resistant starch, or is this a result of research that you've done?
Well, there's been a lot of research in the past 10 years or so. And what happened here was that Francis came to me at the magazine and said, you know, there's a lot of research right now that's saying that there's this kind of carb, resistant starch, which is having an effect on the body that we didn't really understand before. Researchers were doing all kinds of tests, and this is what they were discovering. So we thought, you know what? What hasn't happened here is no one has actually created a diet that incorporates all of this research and information. And so that's what we did.
Now, can you eat these starches throughout the day, even at night, because I always heard that you should have your starchy foods in the morning, and then at night you should have food that doesn't have carbs, like salad before bed, because you need to be active to actually burn the food that you've consumed.
Well, what's true is that it generally comes down to calories, but then there are different ways to slice 1,200 calories or 1,600 calories, and the way we do it is very filling. So you're getting your resistant starch throughout the day. And you know what? If you're one of those people who you get home late and you have to have dinner at 8 or 9 o'clock, that's okay as long as... right, exactly. She's at the office late. As long as you're keeping your total calories in check.
Right. It's all about how much you're eating. But the beauty of this diet is that you're full. After you eat lunch and you have a snack or so, you're not going to need to eat, you know, the minute you get home. You're going to feel much more, you know, in control.
And the vending machine is not going to be calling your name.
That's right. Absolutely.
See, I think that's where people usually get the most extra pounds and calories is eating between meals. Yeah. And it sounds like with this diet, you can actually be totally full and happy right after lunch. You're not even thinking about food by the time that you get home.
Exactly. And a lot of diets, you know, as we were talking about before, they're so skimpy.
Right.
And, you know, and so it's like it's an undressed salad, you know, with a couple of chicken strips on top.
I hate being hungry.
Right.
That's what the thing I fear most. I
it
really
makes you
don't
it
like
makes you
hunger.
Cranky and not nice to be around. And then you get, you know, later on, you might be able to do that for a while, but then later on you're going to binge on the foods you want.
Right. So, you know, it sounds like really like, you know, the miracle diet, but there must be something that is a challenge to someone looking to do this diet.
Listen, no diet is a miracle. The thing about this diet, though, is that it really does, it's the most normal diet that you can possibly imagine that still allows you to lose weight. And we say that it's for life, and we mean it. It really is something that is going to help you get control of your eating, feel good, feel energetic, and then really be able to stick with this way of eating for the rest of your life. That's what the people who've been on it and have succeeded have told us.
Have you guys done the diet?
Well, you know, I stick to the principles. Let's put it that way. You know, start the day with oatmeal and a banana, and then try to work in those resistant starches throughout the day. Absolutely. I've put a new focus on it.
I had the banana shake this morning, and it was great. And I had a lot of energy, completely full. I highly recommend it.
That sounds great. Rick, do we have any questions from the chat room for these ladies about this new diet? We were having some technical difficulties, but I know.
Thank you.
And let's just take another look at the book so people can recognize it.
Book.
Absolutely gorgeous.
Well, and the other thing we want to say is we've got a pocket guide version of the Carb Lovers Diet coming out, which has got a lot more of the kinds of foods that are grab and go, how to eat Carb Lovers at the mall. We've also got an app coming out, so
comes out in February, right?
The app comes out in February. Yes.
Great. So we'll keep an eye out for that. Thank you so much, ladies. It was a pleasure to meet you.
Thanks for stopping by.
Happy holidays. I'll be sure to keep those tips in mind when I'm at my holiday parties later on today.
Sounds great.
Thank you.